Shinzan Roshi's 80th birthday just arriving, we're celebrating his work as a Zen artist and calligrapher. We're celebrating here at Yugagyo Dojo, our dojo in London. We have an exhibition of his artworks, mostly created during his 80th year. Like many of the great Zen masters, later on in life is when the artistic side really emerges. And here, Shinzan Roshi, in his 80s, is really probably reaching a level of artistic accomplishment that he's never touched before. So we have a spectacular collection of very varied styles. We have works which are very powerful, very blocky, very strong. We have works which are very lyrical and flowing. We have pictures and we have pure calligraphy. So it's quite a selection. I want to give you a little sampling of some of the works here. First, let's have a little look at these two. Now, our exhibition designer has paired up these two because of their artistic similarity. They've both got this kind of long tail on them with the flying white, as it's called, the white showing through the ink. This one here, Chu Do. Chu means middle or center, Do way. The middle way is kind of the central imagery within Buddhism. Also, there are deeper ramifications of what that's about, what that means, that really come to light in sustained meditation practice. And Shinzan Roshi's really kind of emphasized that central quality within the character there. So this one here is the character Yume, or Dream. And it's actually got a number of meanings, as the English word dream does. The central one, from a Zen perspective, is a line from the Diamond Sutra, the Buddha's teaching, which says, basically, we should regard the world as a dream. Merrily, 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 merrily. So we have this long, kind of extended tail that parallels the Chudo, the character next to it. It's a kind of a really nice example of the freedom of brushwork that Shinzan Roshi is kind of enjoying. Now this character here also has this long extended tail that Shinzan Roshi has deliberately done. This time you'll notice he's used a much wetter, softer ink than the previous ones. Now what he's depicting here is the character Taki, or waterfall. And he uses very wet, soft ink to kind of emphasize that kind of cool, soft quality. Often a scroll like this would be hung in the summer months when there's a kind of a real need for a little bit of refreshment, a little bit of cooling. Also, the Taki, or the waterfall, symbolizes the kind of arising of, or rather the descending of, blessings when we truly enter our place of meditation. It's like we're sitting in this beautiful waterfall of blessings constantly, constantly, constantly pouring through us. So you can really get a feel for that constancy in the way this character is depicted. Behind this is a long, long course of training. He's described to me studying with his own teachers. He would simply be present in the studio with his own the Zen masters he was studying with while they were working. He would be holding paper, laying out paper. Sometimes they'd ask him to apply the seals after the work was done. This kind of thing, just really exploring and seeing and experiencing how these works are created. And it's a very great honor and a privilege to bring these works to the attention of the people of London and to enrich the cultural life of London in this way. So let's just look at these two contrasting versions of the Enso, or the famous Zen circle. This one here has the inscription, basically, peace is the most precious thing. And it's got a very peaceful quality about it, a real sense of soft presence. Contrasts very strongly with this one, which is perhaps as bold as it could possibly be. The inscription inside says, Kensho Jogutsu, seeing or knowing your true nature, becoming a Buddha. And Shinzan Roshi is physically depicting the power that's present within that great realization. So we have a very peaceful Enso, we have a very dynamic Enso, both simply a circle, and yet so much can be shown in the contrast. So here we have a very powerful, very spectacular calligraphy, each character very strongly depicted. It says, one true man of no rank, or true person of no rank. The key teachings of Zen master Rinzai, the founder of the Rinzai lineage of Zen. And Rinzai was famous for being a very powerful, very direct, very no-nonsense teacher. And we have a sense of that kind of controlled power and yet clarity within the way that Shinzan Roshi has depicted this key phrase. This is very likely one of the most spectacular ensos or Zen circles you're likely to see, created by our teacher Shinzan Roshi in 2011, literally in this hall. It's never left this hall since it's been made. Now, when we talked about creating this, Shinzan Roshi asked me to find him the biggest brush in London. And I went to various of the art schools, talked to friends who are artists, looked at art shops and so on. Couldn't find anything anywhere near big enough. So this actually, in the event, was created with a brand new floor mop. Shinzan Roshi did one practice run with water, just got a sense of the dynamics of the handling the mop, and then this was what resulted. Just about perfect, I think you'll agree. Spectacular. Remains the centerpiece of our training hall here to this day. I'd like to invite you to our art exhibition called The Zen Character, running from the 3rd to the 5th of July at our dojo, which is called Zen Yoga, 2D Camberwell Road, down at Camberwell in London. Our nearest railway station is Denmark Hill. Now, during those dates, the exhibition is running during the day and also in the evening. Also, on Sunday, 5th of July, as part of the exhibition, Shinzan Roshi himself, the artist, will be presenting a calligraphy workshop. You can come along, try it out for yourself. That's running from 10 until 1 on Sunday the 5th. Works are for sale. There's also various souvenirs, books, and so on. It's a pretty rare opportunity to see freshly created Zen art from a teacher who's got about a half a century of Zen practice behind his work. It's a good one. Please come.